Good evening, everybody. Quick look at some numbers outside. Kind of the overruling story this week. It was warm, then it got cold with the rain. 42 outside right now, and I mean, that's not terrible, but an average overnight low should be 42, and we should just stop here as far as cooling off. Unfortunately, we're not going to. We're going to keep getting colder tonight. Watch Futurecast take the clouds and slowly begin to move them out, and as it does, temperatures will be in the mid-30s to start the day. Take a look at your lows tonight. Again, about 34 for Rockville, 35 in Robinson. This will be the overnight lows after midnight and what it's going to feel like when we start the day tomorrow. So we'll start off at 34. Look at that climb to 58, 59. Yeah, that's a decent afternoon, but your average is about 65. So we're going to be running about 5 to 10 degrees in some areas below average again tomorrow. But it is going to be warmer tomorrow than what it was today. Futurecast after 8 o'clock gets those temperatures up, as we mentioned, into the upper 50s, a few lower 60s to the south. But notice the clouds move out a bit. So we'll have some sunshine out there tomorrow, more than we had today. And overnight lows tomorrow are not going to be as cold, but daytime highs, as mentioned, upper 50s, lower 60s from north to south there. So a decent afternoon, in all honesty. It's going to be a little bit breezy, though. I think that'd be the only real problem with tomorrow, besides it being slightly below average. And notice Sunday morning, only about 40. So that number, too, is warmer than what we are going to deal with tonight, and still just a little bit below average. Well, then we go to the other side of the equation. Average high 65. We jump all the way up into the lower 70s outside. This is for Sunday afternoon. Winds will be out of the south. Going to be a bit of a breezy day. More sunshine expected, but by 6 p.m., quite a bit of sunshine and warmer temperatures out west. There is a line of some rain showers trying to move back through, and with that line, there's going to be a minimal chance for some severe weather, but it's basically day-to-day isolated thunderstorms. We're going to go from cold now, or cooler than average now, back into a very spring-like pattern where it's active. It's unsettled, and we have those day-to-day chances for rain showers. Big picture shows us the clouds that have been out there really didn't produce much rain for us. There was some organized rain farther to the north, but here at home, it basically was just some sprinkles every now and then. That's going to be the rule again anytime that we've got the clouds tonight before they slowly break up. But notice down here, Knox, Davies, and Martin counties all the way south to Evansville, down into southern Illinois. The skies have cleared there, so that's some good news. If the sun were up, you'd see it. It's just not up, of course, right now. So a bit breezy and 34, partly cloudy. That is your forecast tonight. Those winds will be out of the west at about 10 to 15 miles per hour for the overnight hours tonight. 59 tomorrow, gusty winds out of the west at times, gusting near 25 miles per hour, just below 60 for a daytime high. 40 tomorrow night, so not as cold. Not as cold as it has been, but that's still below average a bit. And your 7-day forecast, really not bad, but scattered day-to-day thunderstorms are back. So this week, when we were going from Sunday to about Wednesday, it was an unsettled pattern. We had a chance for rain each day, with that really falling on Wednesday. Then it got colder and quiet for a couple of days, and that's where we are now, colder and quiet. But as you can see, it jumps back up, and then next week back to being unsettled before it cools off. High of 52 next Friday, Patrice, so the roller coaster's going on.